Hello viewers, I welcome you today to Back to Basics in Gospel Half Hour. I am, once again, your host, Reverend Udeh Mekman. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you once again this evening in thanks and appreciation to all your very many mercies that you've showered over our lives. We pray, Lord, that you speak to us today. The scripture states that the entrance of your word gives light and gives understanding to the simple. And so we pray, Eternal Father, that you speak to us through your word. In Jesus' name. Amen. Today we're reading from 1 Chronicles and chapter 29. 1 Chronicles chapter 29, we just take a verse. That's verse 3. Besides, in my devotion to the temple of my God, I now give my personal treasures of gold and silver for the temple of my God. Over and above everything, I have provided for this holy temple. We are speaking on the topic, what to do with your church. What to do with your church. Several times, the word church is presented as if it is just the people that worship. And so when we see people that come from a particular church, we say that is the choir church, that is the apostolic church people coming. Yes, God loves them, but God also loves the place that his name is put, his place of worship. God loves it and reverence it. And so today, briefly, as Christians, what do we do with our church? What do we do to it? How do we treat it? Number one, the portion we read in 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verse 3. David spoke in wonderful, beautiful terms. He says, because of my devotion, of course, the other word translated devotion is love. Because of my love for my church, because of my devotion to my church, I have decided to put aside this and this and this and this to help her grow, to help my son use it to build the church. It's beautiful. So the first thing we learn is that the church should be loved. Our church, are you a Catholic? Are you an Anglican? Are you a Methodist? Are you of the Mount Zion? Are you of the Quaker stock? The scripture says your church, where you fellowship, where you stay, should be loved. That place should be admired. Add emotions to it. A Christian should be in love with his place of worship. He should not only like the place, should not only like the pastor, but should love it. He should attach passions to it. He should add emotions to it. This kind of love should produce concern. David said, I love it so much that I've decided to provide certain things to help the church grow. What do you think about your church? Where do you fellowship? How serious is your devotion to the church? Don't you think of fixing, even if it means one door to the church? That is a sign you have a devotion to the church. You love the church. The worship place should be loved. Number two, in Psalms 122 verse 1, the Bible states very, very clearly, I rejoice with those who said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Besides loving the church should be attended with joy, not with long faces, with smiling faces. You don't go to church to fight. You don't go for wrestling or a boxing context. Rather, you go there with a heart full of joy and gratitude. The psalmist in Psalms 84 verses 1, 2, and 10 states, how lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord Almighty. My soul yearns, even faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. And in verse 10, it says, better is one day in your court than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. So the house of the Lord should be loved. It should be attended with joy. And in 2 Chronicles chapter 30 and verse 1, the Bible records so clearly that the house of the Lord should be advertised. Of course, we hear when the king Hezekiah took time to advertise the courtyard of the Lord in 2 Chronicles 30 verse 1. And in 2 Chronicles 30 verse 5, he said, let this be published from Dan to Beersheba. Talk well about it. Advertise it. If you can't advertise your church, do you need to advertise the juju priests and their shrines? If you can't advertise your church, is it the shrines of the witch doctors that you'll advertise? Talk well about it. Number four, how do we treat our church? What do we do to the church? In Micah chapter 4 and verse 2, the scripture makes us to know that the church should be attended in great multitude. That reminds us of what the scripture says in Isaiah 2 verse 3. It states, many people will come and say, come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. That is a reflection of Micah 4 verse 2. Many people will come and they will say, come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. The house of the Lord, number one, should be loved. Two, should be attended with joy. Three, should be advertised. And four, should be attended in great multitude. Wait a minute. Dear listeners, what do you do to the church? What do you say about your church? Do you destroy leaders by what you say? I pray that the good Lord in his mercy will help us as children of God. This message, of course, is for those who are children of God, who have a worship center in the house of their God. May he help us to know the will of the Lord concerning our worship center. The Lord bless you as you listen to this telecast. Once again, I am your host, Reverend Udeh Mekban. I pray that you keep on watching this program, Gospel Half Hour. It's a beautiful one. You're welcome.